Jason, we just may see, the Dow Industrials has literally, 10, they got 17 minutes to not go down another 0.4%, or the circuit breaker is going to basically break.
I know. I was just thinking, right, as you were going to commercial, I was like, I don't think we get there, and now, you know, it popped a little lower. It's going to be obviously, you know, interesting to watch it come into close. It's going to be hard to hold overnight. You know, be interesting to see if we get the circuit breakers by 50-50 right now. But
yeah,
it's going to be close.
Oh, it is. It's quite a day, man. It's quite a day. So,
man, I woke up this morning, man. I was like, I'm just going to pretend it's Friday. It's summer. You know,
yeah,
it's close enough. The market didn't cooperate, though, right? Like, funny how it works that way sometimes, huh?
Sure. So where do you want to start?
Man, I mean, it's everywhere, right? I loved your analysis on, you know, gold and how some of the other asset classes. Clearly, oil's way off. You know, I think there's meaningful, you know, sometimes it's hard. You know, you have, like, Market Watch and other news feeds put out headlines, and they're just trying to make sense of stuff that's going on. But, you know, I feel genuine fear in the market, and I feel like folks are finally waking up at some level to a reasonable possibility of a second wave metastasizing in some form. And I think that's hit energy. Obviously, you had the build in oil, which is problematic too. Maybe it's not necessarily folks are bent on a second wave as much as they just, you know, realize that the first one is still impactful.
Sure.
But to me, the jump in energy is down is or oil is as impactful or important as the jump lower in equities. I loved your analysis on the island top. You don't see those patterns too often, but that's one of those. Whether or not you trade chart patterns or not. That one's hard to argue with. You know, when it happens, it happens.
Yes.
And this is clearly, to me, an island top. I love your thoughts there. You know, I've been saying for a while I expect it to go lower. I think it's personally just the beginning. This has been set up for a while. I was surprised it didn't happen earlier. You know, and stuff folks haven't talked enough about. You know, you look at individual investors. You had stocks like, you know, signs to me, you know, Chesapeake files for bankruptcy and jumps to 70. You know, just insane.
Yes.
Hertz files for bankruptcy, jumps. You know, individual traders are getting hurt. They're piling into things that they don't fully understand. It's a sign of a top, you know. I got a call Tuesday night from somebody asking me about cruise lines.
Yep.
And piling into Robinhood, you know.
It's amazing. What's amazing, folks, as Jason and I are just talking about the aspect of what happens at tops, it happens every time, folks. I mean, when there's a major top every time, and we'll find out what's going to be a major top again. The market runs in an incredible way. You read the stories about, you know, I don't know if you saw the story in the journal yesterday. It was amazing. The story was about was the Robinhood traders. It was about one guy. It was about Carl Icahn selling all his shares at 73 cents, right?
Right.
It was, and what happened, folks, on the other side of that trade, he wasn't buying all the shares, but on the other side of that trade, a person that had never traded the marketplace took his life savings, $59,000, put it into Hertz. And guess what? He made $49,000 the next day. He made $49,000. Now, that's not the end of the story, though, because Jason and I and all you folks that have been trading for a while, you know how this story goes. It's always a sad story.
That's right.
Takes the money. He said, okay, I'm going to put another $16,000 in. And, you know, so bottom line, he still should be up. My point more than anything, folks, goes like this. We have those stories. Then you have a day like today. And my understanding, Jason, is that at the beginning of today, I don't know if it's still down, the Robinhood system was down. So
right.
Now, even if you are a decent trader and you could take your losses, folks, you can't get out. That is a heavy scene, man.
That's right. And you have the technical issues of Robinhood. What I was telling this gentleman who called me, it was Tuesday night. You know, we're up at highs. We're back. NASDAQ's hitting record highs. Look, in this environment, liquidity to me is more important than price, right?
Yes.
And, you know, folks will have paper gains. They may even be able to cash out there a little earlier than their friends. But you've got a lot of folks heading for the exits. You know, it's as you said, it's a story as old as the markets. But folks who aren't as experienced or haven't done enough education or listened to, you know, folks like you long enough don't understand. it's not about price at this point. It's about liquidity. You have to be able to exit what the screen says, you know.
Right.
Too often you can. And if your whole Chesapeake or Hertz trying to hit the exits, you know. Right. And I read the same thing. You know, Carl Icahn's been around for a while for a reason. He's not always right. But you had folks buying Chesapeake because it was down and the market was going up. It was going to go up. But, they don't know what, bankruptcy means. Or they didn't even, look.
No,
they're just looking for something, and it's like, there's only one thing that can happen when they file for bankruptcy, man. There's only one thing that can happen to the stock. You know that.
Exactly. You may have heard me say this before. What I still just can't understand, folks, is that when the equity files for bankruptcy, why the SEC lets it continue to trade? Because this is a situation, just as Jason said, I bet 80 to 90% of those folks don't realize that they're buying something that's bankrupt, that those equity is not going to be worth anything anymore. In fact, you know what? And in the same article, folks, what happened is that this guy that was doing it, he was making a case that, hey, no, the Hertz name is worth something. This is worth something. I'm saying to myself, oh, my God, this is so sad. Hertz's name is worth something, folks, but it's called the balance sheet, okay? And the right-hand side is very loaded,
It's over. Yeah.
It's over.
And you see what's happened to the cruise lines today, Boeing. It's just the stocks. And I tell folks, it's like a Yogi Berra saying, I use it times like this, but if it doesn't make sense, it doesn't make sense,
Which is so tough when the market keeps going up and you haven't been the market for a while, right?
I mean, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'll be honest. I'll be the first to admit, I thought this was going to happen a couple weeks ago, and I've been waiting for it for a couple of weeks. I'm, wrong all the time. It was going to happen,
We know we take heat. There's no doubt about it. What happens, folks, is that, when you trade both sides of the market, you take heat. There's no doubt about it, man. It's, you just have to make sure that you're not over your head as you're taking the heat. It gets a little bit easier when those stories come out, I can tell you that, because it's like, okay, man, And in particular, I can totally understand why the digital stocks inside the NASDAQ, too. I mean, we're moving, and I'm moving. You know what I'm saying? I get that. But we know that when you take five stocks, or let's say 10 stocks, that is not the whole market. That is, equity's taking market share in an incredible way, So
that's right. That's right, man.
As we're talking here, so watch this, folks. We're at 6.93% in the Dow Industrials.
Right,
you only need a few more points, and you're going to see a halt. And the Dow Industrials has 9 minutes. We're at 3.26. Here it goes.
It's close enough. I mean, I think we're probably at a 75% chance at this point.
Oh, my God. I'm telling you, man.
We got a VIX at, 40. It's going to be a wild day tomorrow. Again, Friday's in the summer, typically lighter volume.
Friday, pretty amazing. Well, listen, man, it's always a pleasure. You have
love
a great
it,
weekend, safe weekend.
I
we
can't
look
wait.
Forward to speaking next Tuesday, Jason.
All right, Tom, can't wait, man.
Thanks, man. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow Industrials down 1843. NASDAQ up 506. S&P's up 182. We'll come right back.